One of the questions that I get a lot is, how do you control your thoughts, Vaisakh? How do you keep the negative thoughts in check and make sure most of the time you have positive thoughts? Is there some way to make sure that these negative thoughts don't affect you? What I want to tell you guys is that even I am affected by negative thoughts. During a day, lots of negative thoughts come into my mind. Sometimes I might be simply sitting and daydreaming when suddenly the thought of my mom dying comes into my mind, or me getting into an accident and losing one of my limbs and living as a handicap also comes into my mind. But do you know the main thought that affects me? It usually comes when I am sitting to study or to read some book. Suddenly some hot girl comes into my mind from some magazine or some video that I have seen long back, and it affects my mind and it makes me miserable. So how do I overcome it? I can tell you lots of ways in which I overcome this, but I think I'll tell you a story first, because all the tips that I give you, you will forget within an instant, but a good story will stay with you just like the story stayed with me. So where did I get the story from? Again, one fine morning, I was sitting on my couch and relaxing and daydreaming about how awesome I was, when suddenly my mom came to me and like, "Mone, nanku oru katha kekkanum." I was like, "Okay, kekkalo." It means what my mom said was, "Son, do you want to hear a story?" And I was like, "Okay, go on, mom." And then she told me the story of a guru and his disciple. Let's name the disciple Abhinav for convenience sake. One fine day, Abhinav was at his master's ashram and was trying to meditate. But all these negative thoughts was bothering Abhinav and he was not able to meditate. So finally he gave up and he asked his master, "Master, I'm not able to meditate. What should I do? I'm not able to focus at all." The master smiled and told Abhinav, "I don't want you to meditate now. I want you to do something for me." Abhinav was like, "Oh, master is going to ask something great for me to do." The master asked Abhinav, "There is a hen outside our ashram. I want you to go and observe the hen. Just observe the hen. Do not disturb it no matter what." Abhinav was perplexed. "Whoa, here I am trying to meditate and all these negative thoughts are coming, and master is asking me to go and observe a hen? What kind of nonsense is this?" Okay, now Abhinav did not voice this concern because he had great respect for his master. Abhinav knew that there was always a purpose and inner meaning when the master asked him to do something. So he went outside the ashram, sat on the veranda and observed the hen. He observed the hen for 15 minutes. He didn't notice anything special. But after some time, he noticed a pattern. The hen used to choose a particular portion of the land, and then it used to go there and claw over it. Cluck, 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 cluck. It used to keep on clawing. And what he noticed was that the hen was actually separating the dirt, the dust, the gravel, the stones, and all other unwanted material, and was just pecking and eating the grains and insects which it wanted. Once that particular area was covered, the hen used to choose another portion of the land, go over there and again cluck cluck cluck, do the same procedure, sort off the entire dirt, gravel, dust, sand, and eat only the insects and the grains which would fill it. While Abhinav was noticing this pattern, his master came from behind and patted his shoulder. "Look at the hen, Abhinav, and look at the piece of land. The land is our mind. It is filled with good thoughts, bad thoughts, negative thoughts, terrible thoughts, neutral thoughts, and so on. The hen represents our willpower. We have to constantly flex our willpower and, just like the hen, sort out the negative thoughts from the good thoughts and keep on focusing on the thoughts which gives us peace of mind and gives us happiness. Just like the hen, you should never give up. Your willpower is like a muscle. You have to constantly keep on working it out. Then only you will be able to continuously have a good stream of positive thoughts instead of negative ones." So coming back to the point, what do I do when such thoughts of my mom dying or me getting in an accident or all such negative thoughts come? I do not try to stop them. I tell myself, let it come, let it all come. But I make sure that I replace it with some happy thoughts of me going to a theater with my mom, or me traveling safely on my car, and so on. It's just like when I tell you guys, do not imagine an elephant wearing a red shirt. Whoa, what happened? You actually imagined an elephant wearing a red t-shirt, right? Similarly, when negative thoughts come into your mind, you should not beat yourself up and tell, oh my god, such negative thoughts are coming into my mind, what do I do? What happens is, when you do like that, you are actually giving your power to the negative thoughts and they keep on coming with more force. Instead, what you do is, you tell, okay, let it come, let it all come in. But you continuously keep on replacing it with something else. Negative thought comes, you replace it. Negative thought comes, you replace it. Come, replace. This will keep on going until a time will come when it becomes a natural process. Negative thoughts will keep on coming, but you will keep on replacing it with good thoughts without any kind of conscious control. It's just like when you're starting to drive a car, you hold it, you do not know where the gears are, you forget to check the mirrors. But once you become an expert, when you have driven a car for like 5 to 10 years, all this comes with an ease. Similarly, you are replacing negative thoughts with positive thoughts will become a second nature to you. I know it's going to be hard, especially for people with obsessive compulsive disorders. There are some people who have certain negative thoughts and then they are not able to replace it. For them, it will be a bit more harder, but this is what all of us needs to do. Believe me, this fight is going on within each of us at every moment in our life. The successful ones among us are the ones who have not yet given up. Once we give up, the negative thoughts will have their power over us. So I hope this helped you guys a bit. And now, the next time a negative thought or a hot chick comes into your mind, it won't bother you. But what do? You replace it. So that's it for today's video. And I hope you can give me a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe to my channel and do give me a like. So until next time, have a nice day and bye.